All right, so here we are live with the third Red Glove interviews, this time with Dana Simovic. At the moment, I'm myself in another city. This is not Sweden. As you can see, the background, it's quite interesting stuff that's happening, you know, and I really like to change the environments. I'm in Cluj, Transylvania, Romania, where the old meets the new. Let's put it like that, you know, so it's a very exciting room. I mean, I'm just waiting for Dracula to show up. So I hope that the interview will be finished before that. Dana Simovic is a very, very interesting person. And every time I meet her, you know, I'm thinking of some of the things that I should have done, you know, because she took a decision quite late in her life that I know many of us are thinking about and sometimes even telling others about, but we kind of never get there, you know. And in order to, you're going to hear more about it soon, but in order to take that decision so drastically and radically like she did, that takes a lot of courage. And then to create what she's been creating and, you know, going on with that, that is nothing short than amazing, you know. So Dana, you're welcome to the third interview tonight. And you're in Sweden, right?
Yes, I am. Thank you, Claudio, for inviting me here tonight, and to you all who listen to us now. Thank you so much. Yes, I'm in Sweden, in Stockholm just now.
Okay. And how did we meet? Just to short, to give the audience, you know, where our connection is, and how did we meet? Do you remember?
Yes, I remember. I think it was around 3 years ago. We have a common friend.
Yes.
We were starting to talk about you, about Claudio, that you should meet this man. But it took 2 years before we met, and that was last year. We met each other first time.
Yes.
1 year ago, since then, we have met each other a few times.
Yes.
In Malmö. I remember.
In Malmö, yeah.
Yes.
At a coffee shop, I think. It
yes.
Was, yeah. Yeah, and you told me all about the crazy stuff that you're doing. And I said, hey, you know, we really need to get your message out there so more people can you know, get to know you and get to know the good stuff that you're doing. So we have been working on that, you could say, you know, had some seminars together and,
yes,
you know,
you
yeah, build some more channels. Yeah.
So thank you for supporting me.
Yeah, it's my
this
pleasure.
Way.
It's
and
my pleasure.
The Uganda project. Thank
yes.
you so much.
Well, other people are supporting me, you know, and have supported
yes,
me. So
yes,
it gives
yes.
me a lot of, especially when it's such a strong message and a great project that you're doing, you know. So before we dive into the questions,
okay.
I'm really, really pumped here, you know. I, as usual, start with the three things that you're most grateful for, because I think the gratitude is among the first things that should be activated in order to achieve any kind of results, especially long term, you know. So if you could please share with us the three things that you're most grateful for, it would be really great.
Wow, three things. Yes, that is so nice to be grateful. Do you know, I'm very grateful when I wake up in the morning and I'm a healthy person. That's very important. I'm so grateful for that. And then I'm very grateful that I find my purpose in life, I must say.
Mm.
And I'm grateful for my family, my children, my grandchildren, my sister and brothers. I love them so much. I'm so grateful to have them.
That's awesome.
Yes.
That's awesome. Yeah. Really important things that you say there. And it's, you know, it's not everyone that actually has them, especially when you talk about, you know, being healthy and, I mean, just having a purpose. You know, I know a lot of people that haven't found their purpose and they're still looking for it. And it's not easy. You know, sometimes it can take a lot of time until you find it, you know.
It did. It took me 50 years before I find it. So it's
so
never too late.
How did you find it? Let's go into that. How did you get, you know, in doing what you're doing right now? Can you tell us a little bit about
yes,
what happened?
Yes, it was really not my plan, really, to do this, what I'm doing. It was on a bus journey in Uganda. I was sitting on the bus, And there was a lady, she was throwing out a water bottle, empty water bottle from the bus window. And my journey, like I see today, the purpose in my life, starts from this water bottle. And I went home to Sweden, I was starting to think, what can I do? They have a lot of health problems in Uganda and Africa who start from unclean environment. Then my thought went to the children, to go to the schools. And I create a Dana program about environment, clean environment and health programs. So it started with a water bottle. It was like a seed for me, you know. And I started to planting that seed.
Okay. 5 years ago. But were you, I'm just curious, you know, when you say you were on a bus and in Uganda, was that like a, were you a tourist? You just decided, hey, I want to, you know, see how Uganda was, or were you there to seek out some projects, or?
No, it was like this. 2010, I went down to Uganda. That was the first time I was in Africa. Mm-hmm. We was 10 person to do something else, a business opportunity. So I had really a plan for my life. I had a plan and everything, and this water bottle changed my life totally. This moment in the bus changed my plan, my life, and everything. Because this was even not my dream to do these kind of things in Africa.
Wow.
So you see, we have a lot of those moments around us. We just need to catch them.
Yeah.
And the courage to continue with them if you really feel something strong about them.
Mm. So that water bottle was the thing that actually activated the whole journey.
Yes, that's my story, my own adventure.
Yeah. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. So now you're going back and forth, what I know, to Uganda, right?
Yes.
Because every second time I call you, I'm in Uganda, Claudio. And then you're back home to lobby and, you know, to spread your message. Then you're back in Uganda. So how many times a year are you in Uganda?
Around 3 times. So I'm going on Friday again. So good that we're talking
there
today.
We go. Yeah. Yeah, and we wanted to do this interview maybe from Uganda, but we were not sure about the internet connection, right?
Yes, so it was better to do it now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Awesome. Okay, so when you were younger, let's say, or smaller or younger, did you have a superhero? And if you had one, which one was that?
Oh, superhero when I was young. Let's see.
Or now. That's fine.
No. But we can take when I was young, because we was reading those magazines, you know.
Yeah.
And there was a magazine, Fantomen and Diana. Do you remember
okay.
that?
Yeah, I remember Fantomen.
Yes, it was like Tarzan and Jane. You know Tarzan and Jane.
Yeah.
But Fantomen and Diana I liked very much because they were on an adventure all time. And I liked that magazine very much. Yes.
So that was, Mm-hmm. There is a saying in Swedish, hård men rättvis som fantomen. You know, I'm very harsh, but very fair, like the phantom, you know, if you translate. You know.
Mm. That was my hero somehow. I liked that magazine when I was young, yes.
Okay, and it was because of the adventure surrounding the phantom?
Yeah, good things to solve, good things.
Mm. Yeah. Do you remember
against
that?
Against the bad.
Yeah.
Yes.
Do you remember? Sorry for just came up to me. Do you remember that the Phantom had a dog, a white dog, or
a
white wolf?
Yes, I remember. Mm-hmm.
Do you remember the name of that?
No, I don't.
No. Neither do I. Maybe someone watching can actually write in the comments. Yeah. I know someone will, obviously. Mm-hmm. We can check it. Okay, so what is your definition? Because as we have spoken in previous interviews, you know, we live in a society where the word success is overabundant. It's everywhere. Everybody's chasing success, you know, get successful in 3 steps, follow this, you know, 7 steps to get there faster. You know, so everybody's talking about success, but very few have a definition of what success for me. Because it's very different from person to person. So what is your definition of success, Dana?
Success for me is, I must say, when you wake up in the morning and you do something you feel so good about, you find something you just like to do. That is success, to find something you love to do. That
okay.
is success to me, really. Because
so is that
of people are doing things they maybe don't like, but they just do it because they like to be in the comfort zone and continue what they do. But to find something when you wake up with a smile in the morning, you cannot wait to start with your thing you love to do. That's success.
That's success. And to be able to do it, not just one morning, you mean, but ongoing.
No, success is to find something you like to do and you continue.
Yes.
To do it and develop whatever it is.
Okay. Thank you. I think we have similar thoughts about that.
Yeah.
Okay, so doing the things you love on a continuous basis and to attach to a purpose, like you said, you know, to have a purpose with that, which obviously, you know, just doing the stuff that you like and love gives you a purpose, you know, because you want to do more of it. All right. So what do you spend a big chunk of your money on, Dana? Can you please tell us?
It's to develop my journey, we can say, what I have found to do, to develop my journey and myself and my purpose. And like it looks now, is this thing I'm doing in Uganda, developing New Africa with the children.
Okay.
I'm very happy when I have money for this. It makes me very happy.
Okay. So that's what gives you most joy, to actually reinvest, you know, the money that you earn, or, you know, be able to attract from other organizations and people and put them in your passion, which is continuing with the project.
Yes.
Am I correct?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Do you have a person, or, you know, could be several, but which one person has had the biggest influence in your life? And what did that person teach you, or say to you? You know,
I have to think. That was not so easy question.
No, it is a hard question.
Yes, but let's see. I have to go back when I was young. When I was between 20 and 35, there was an old lady, her name was Eva.
Okay.
And she was there for me. She was a very wise woman. And she somehow was there for me, like a young woman, like a mother, and even later to try to find my way to see myself somehow, not just my children, to see myself. So she was very important for me between I was 20 and 35 years.
Okay. So did she tell you, like, the one thing that she taught you was to be able to see yourself more?
Yes.
And not just focus on the others?
Yes, because she saw my problem. I didn't see myself, just my family, you know.
Okay. So you're doing everything for other people and for your family, but you didn't take care and saw yourself and what you really wanted to.
Yes.
That's big. That's big.
Yes, it's really, I must say.
Yes.
So,
I hope she's watching.
Fantastic. No, she's not here with us, but she was a fantastic person. That was an old lady even then.
Okay.
Not with us now.
No. Well, maybe she is. We never know.
On that plan, technology.
Yeah, on that different dimension.
Yes.
All right. Do you have any books, or do you have like a favorite book that has, you know, helped you the most, or, you know, changed the way you're thinking, or gave you some, you know, more inspiration than usual? Do you have one of those books that, hey, this is something that I would recommend to my friends? And
it's a lot of books.
They are.
But on this journey, you know, with Eve, I was talking about, there was a book around 20 years ago. The name is The Ninth Insight.
Yeah, yes.
I think when I was reading that book 20 years ago, a process started with myself more to look at myself and the earth and how we together can make the world better somehow.
So the ninth insight, right?
Yeah. So that is almost 20 years ago, was very powerful for me.
Okay.
To grow like a person, I think, when I read that book.
Yeah. Wow, I'm gonna pick that book up because this is actually, it's crazy that you're saying that, because this was one of the books that I got recommended while I was climbing Kilimanjaro last year. So a fellow climber from Denmark, Susanne Knutsen. I don't know if she's watching. If you are, here we go. You know, that she recommended, you know, the book series, because there are several books in that.
Yes, there are.
So now I have to read it, you know, especially when it comes from, yes, I have to, you know. All right, thank you. I want to take this time, I want to take some questions maybe from the people watching, obviously. But before I do that, do you have any like turning point in your life that has defined you and actually made you to take another direction? We heard about the water bottle and when you start looking at yourself more than the others, but do you have another turning point that you can think back and say, hey, that's when I chose to do this instead or to think like this instead?
Yes, it is really, because even 20 years ago, my life was not in balance. Mm-hmm. So I was looking for something to keep myself in balance. Then I found this Chinese medicine they call Qigong.
Oh, yes.
Yes. So that was a big turning point in my life to find balance. So 1997, I started a course. And after that, I went education in 3 years to become a Qigong instructor. So that was the big turning point in my life.
And for the people that don't know what Qigong is, what is Qigong, shortly?
Sometimes I say it's like yoga. Most people know what yoga is. Yoga is from India, Qigong is from China.
Okay.
And this, yes. And this is, you do a kind of movements and breathe technique and even off-slapping. I cannot say it in...
Relaxation, English. Right?
Yes.
Relaxation. Yeah.
So it's a program, you have to go course and train this program. And you should do it every day, at least 30 minutes. And you reduce your stress and you can have balance in some illness you maybe have. So it's a very good method and I have done it for 20 years.
Wow, that's a long time. So it must be good to continue with something for 20 years.
Yes, and it gives you new energy every day, this method.
Awesome. Okay. A lot of people watching, or maybe a lot of people will be watching afterwards too, you know, that are thinking, like I said in the beginning, that, hey, you know, I have this passion, but I don't know. I'm too afraid to take the step to, you know, how can I live on that passion? You know, maybe it's too big, you know. And so what we do is that we continue in the same patterns day by day, waiting for tomorrow. You know, only that will come, then I will do it. You know, only my children will, you know, be 18, then I will be able to do it. And tomorrow, you know, leads to nowhere. You know, so what would you say to those people that maybe have this inner passion or something they want to realize and they're just not doing it right now? What would you say to them?
I will say, don't overthink, just do it and act. Because if you have a feeling for something, don't overthink, start your steps. It doesn't matter. You don't need to see 1 year in front of you. Take it day by day. And if you do it something every day, after 1, 2, 3 years, you will surprise yourself where you are. But you have to believe in yourself. That's number one. Because if you don't believe in you, nobody else will believe in you. You have to believe in yourself and listen really to yourself. And that is courage, to listen to yourself, really. You have to have that courage to listen to yourself and believe and act, really.
So those two together create a powerful force. You know, believe it.
And, right? And even to have patience. Because we are in the earth everything don't need to happen this year, next year, because it took me 5 years from the water bottle where I'm today.
Yeah.
But I did it with patience, with love, with passion. It doesn't matter the time. It's just to do it.
And you helped install a couple of water tanks, right?
Yes, in this training program about health and environment, we help schools with water. So
yeah.
They have water even. So we are very happy to help the schools with that.
That's pretty cool. From a water bottle to the water tanks that you're installing now.
Yes.
That's what you mean with have patience.
Mm. Yes.
Yeah. All right.
And that's very powerful. It's so powerful. Patience is so powerful.
Yeah, it's so hard.
You don't give up. If you are patient, you don't give up.
Yeah, it's hard. But we need to remind ourselves, because we live in a society where everything needs to go fast. I want it now. It's the quick fix, and so on. All right, last question before we take some questions from the people watching. If you had the opportunity... This is a question that I usually finish with. To have one message on a giant billboard so the whole world could see, you know, with the technology available today, just one message that would live on even after you are no longer with us, what would that message be from you for all the people that could see it?
Let's see. There is something I'm using to say when I'm in the schools in Uganda, in Kampala. And there is, if there is a will, there is a way.
That's great.
And keep on going.
If there is a will, there is a way.
There is a way, yes.
Keep on going.
Yes.
Dana Simovic.
Yes, thank you.
Awesome. All right, let's see if you guys have any questions. We can take a couple. If not, we will round it up here. So please comment below. Let's see if we can do it like this. And you will be, for the people in Denmark and Sweden, together with Marie Appelquist, that was, you know, on the interview, and Karen from Singapore, you will be one of the main speakers at the POW event in March, on March 8th in Malmö, right?
Yes. I'm looking forward to that day. Really.
So are we. Today I actually talked to the performer that's coming, Linda Runesson, that's going to be singing for us. Mm. And she's really pumped, and I'm really excited to have her over in Malmö and to give us a great performance, you know. So it's going to be more than just a seminar. It's going to be an experience for 4 hours, you know. And people can find out more in depth about how you did, you know, in going about with what you have with the project and, you know, gaining ground and getting money and getting people involved. And you created, I mean, music videos. And I mean, yeah, it's like a whole planet.
Yes. And you are like a whole planet too. Thank you for all those things you're doing, Claudio. You're fantastic.
Thank you.
We have something in common, you and me, because I know that you like to speak to students.
Yes.
You are at schools.
Yes.
And I like really much what you're doing. These topics you have about to have goals, to take responsibility, and those topics you have for young people. Thank you so much, because they need it.
Yes. Yeah. And so do I, because it gives me a lot of energy, and I'm privileged to be able to do that, you know. So with that, thank you very much. I mean, comment, we can actually answer the comments even after the call has been finished. We can see, you know, the updates.
Yeah.
Have a great evening, and greetings from Transylvania to you, Dana, in Sweden.
Thank
you. Good luck in Uganda.
Yes, thank you. And good luck in Transylvania with Dracula.
Thank you so much. Night is coming. Okay, take care.
Bye.
Bye.